Hello, comic fans. Here's Earl Grey. It's Philip Drouet time once again, and stuff is piling up since my last video about his work. So this video will be a bit longer one, divided into roughly into three parts. The first will be some kind of postscriptum to my raving review about the Titan edition of Ira Gale, Urm the Mad. There has to be some cutback, is in order, and some unfortunately some critique. And another book that is published by Titan Books right now is The Night. And here I have the French original, La Nuit, and German translation, Die Nacht, to give you some kind of impression how this book may look like. I don't have the particular Titan edition. And maybe you have seen some pages of The Night before in one of my videos where I've shown you some of this very beloved book. A book that I haven't read before is Salammbô. And this book here is a really well-made book by Titan Books that recently came out as well. Not well made is Ira Gale, Urm the Mad One, and to be fair, this is the only one where I have this critique, which I will right now come to. It's easy to be blown away by Philippe Drouet's art and to overlook some flaws of a particular edition. I mean, in my video I mentioned at some place the bit blurry reproduction qualities, but I was much too nice, because this is really true for each and every page. Everything is a bit out of focus, is a bit blurry, and the colors are not right. And I will show you, just for comparison, this old soft cover of Ira Gale and done by this very little publisher, Dragon's Dream. This is a true, or was rather, I think, a true European corporation. So take this Brexit. A French publisher doing an English edition printed in the Netherlands. So maybe just here, this double page for comparison. If anything looks here out of focus or blurry, then it's due to my mobile. The printing qualities here are top-notch, and the color is vibrant and brilliant and everything. And if I compare it to the Titan edition, you will see the difference, I think. Just look at the dragon animal buck thing guy here on the left-hand side with the cities on his shoulders, like only Philippe Drouet can do or can up can imagine this stuff here. It looks almost grayish in this new Titan edition. And this book here is again from 1976, yeah, and the guys have did a much better job. And if you look at the colors in the upper left corner, they are almost gone in the Titan edition. So that's a bit embarrassing, I think. And yeah, as I said, it's the only book from Titan so far that had really let me down with their reproduction qualities. So I hope, really hope, that The Night will be a better book than that one. And first and foremost, because of I think of La Nuit still as my favorite book by Philippe Drouet. It's a very basic story, an elementary outcry, a mourning of sorts for his memoir, for his much too soon passed away wife Nicole, for his wife who passed away much too soon. Will be maybe more correct. So, and yeah, and it's very basic, brutal story in the most, in the nicest colors or the most psychedelic colors, of Hell's Angels, kind of motorcycle gang, against some skull dudes, in a post-apocalyptic setting, and they're getting at each other's throats, in the most beautifully way, totally over the top, and for Dries, I just wanted to say almost sketchy, but then you come to see this page here. He collaged photos of his wife in, but just to make the, and I guess their pets, just to make these ugly scenes of total douchebags that kill each other the uglier. And this double page here is maybe one of the best, in a strange way, most beautiful pages of Druyer. Yeah, and they fight each other until a total annihilation, which can't be better depicted than, again, from Philippe Druyer. So, yeah, I had this book for years, not to say decades, so I haven't got really the story, and thought maybe this is due to my French, but then I was able to grab the German translation, Die Nacht, from the old Volksverlag, and figured, hey, the story really is very basic, and these guys can't utter a complete sentence because they're maybe due to atomic radiation or so, not capable any longer of finishing a whole sentence. Maybe it's just the wacky and bad translation, and that's one more reason why I actually want to check out the new English version of this comic as well from Titan, even though the solicits say from Titan, at least on Amazon, that this book, the new book from Titan, should be 15 square 21 centimeters long. So, in case you're not up to snuff with the European measures, I'll show you. 15, this would be mean that this book here is only that wide and roughly 21 centimeters. So, they can't do that, huh? Can't they shrink down this beautiful comic here? One of the most amazing, at least interesting comics of all time to that size? I really hope not, they don't. And what's even crazier, I think when I have enough money after spending for several crazy projects money on comics, I won't go too into details, but maybe when I have some money, I'll even buy this book. And if it's just to rip it apart metaphorically in front of the cam here. Because I really can't believe that they will shrunk that book down, but maybe they will do so. Another thing that I wanted to address earlier with this book here is the strange lettering, the psychedelic lettering. This is the English version, of course, so it's not the original lettering from Philippe Druyer, but he always tried some stuff that is almost not to decipher, but you can read it, and it blends much more with the art, of course. And what they are doing constantly almost constantly in these Titan books here. They replace it with this kind of linear antiqua with serifs, some kind of very readable but a bit boring computer type. And yeah, I will come a bit later on into that, onto that with Salambo, or right now we have Salambo here. And up to right now in the series, this is by far the most pretentious one. I mean, Philippe Drouillet took some text of Gustave Flaubert from the 19th century, and it reads very much like 19th century with all the dust and spider webs, I would say. It's a really dry and stiff text. Not easily to read and not a real joy, but very pompous. And Philippe Drouillet's art style has been a bit polished, more cleaner. I wouldn't say better. I mean, I always do these music references or comparisons if there are right or not. And I often compare Drouillet with Richard Wagner, even though I don't have the first knowledge about the music of Richard Wagner. But this year looks more like some kind of symphonic post-rock, progressive rock to me. As, you know, some kind of these very colorful and sometimes a bit tasteless album covers of the 70s and even 80s. While maybe the Nacht, die Nacht, La Nuit, the night, could as easily bear some kind of more punkish soundtrack. But this year really screams Eloy to me, if you are familiar with this old symphonic prog rock band from the 70s and 80s. Yeah. Today maybe some metal heavy metal band would be glad to have some art of this fashion on their cover. So what it's all about, it's actually, despite of all the high words and pompousness of Gustave Flaubert, a really basic story, like The Night, actually, some douchebags getting at each other's throats, and but in a much bigger scale. And it's Gustave Flaubert's tale, obviously, tells us the story that took place in ancient Carthage, Northern Africa, where some barbarians weren't paid properly by them, so they plotted some kind of revenge. So, and the barbarians, in the end, eventually went to war against Carthage, which it got a bit more complicated when the chief of the barbarians, the chief douchebag, Mato, fell in love with the daughter of the Carthaginian leader. And as you can imagine, that doesn't end too well. So we have a lot of stuff. Despite of the basic story, there's a lot of stuff that is has to be squeezed between these two covers here. And the more so because of Drouillet's decision to blend this with this Lone Sloan epic. So the leader of the barbarians is actually Lone Sloan, that came from the stars, and spoilers, will go to the stars in the end. But actually the story is of no really interest for anyone, I think. You have in the end these strange computer graphics, which were maybe totally awesome back in the day. Totally new, of course, but today they look really strange. So, yeah, what can I tell you? This story here really has a lot of fight scenes, really huge war scenes that get a bit repetitious over the run of the book here. And all these text blocks that add up to no information, but just to underline the emotion, so that I got the feeling that it's really not wanted, maybe, that we read this stuff here. Just take it as a part of the decoration, but therefore the new lettering of Titans. Titan isn't really beautiful enough. And then, just to get this out of my way, the lettering here, the font is really strange. And I have a part of this book here. This is a trilogy, three books. And it's a good thing that they collected it in one edition. Originally, it came out in three tomes, and this is the second of them. And And the printing quality of this one here is clearly worse, or not as good as the Titan book. The Titan book wins, really. They improved the printing quality. So more power to them. And that has to be said while I was so critical before. But the lettering here, this is the usual lettering, or the lettering that Druyer developed or used for his comic. This is really how it should look like. It's a bit, it's much more decorative and blends better, far better with the art in this comic here. And look at this here. I don't care too much for the story, but man, the art here is fantastic. And I think if you are into this kind of over pompous, full-blown, using everything that you have, and again, there will be some photos in it which don't blend to as good as they did in the older The Night book. And this is his new girlfriend or wife at 10 years later or so. And even these African masks, they blend in some way into the story here. And some critics say the art here is has no really connection to the story. In a way, this is true. In a way, it's not, because I see these pictures here as some kind of details of the whole setting, some kind of different depiction of the same story. So, yeah, he could left these pictures totally, and the story would have not been harmed. But again, you could leave easily a lot of panels and text out of the story, and we would get the main plot, the gist of the story here. For sure. So, yeah, the art is amazing, sometimes a bit too polished in a way, and the story is really, yeah, not what will draw you into this book here, for sure. So yeah, it's an interesting mishmash of feelings I'm left behind. Maybe I can show you in this art book here. We have some original or reproductions from the original art for Salambo. So if you're an Druyer fan, I think you have to get this Salambo book, of course, because it's a very important hallmark of Philippe Druyer, and maybe it's the high point or the first high point. I'm a bit afraid of his pretentiousness, but who does comics in this fashion here? It looks this way here. And here we have the original font of Philippe Druyer. And I think Titan could have done their English translation with this font easily. And it would be so much better, especially since Salambo is full of that font. And it would be easier to blend the text from Flaubert out when it's not necessary to understand it and just to go with the flow of these amazing pictures. Yeah. I feel that I'm taken away by the beauty of Druyer's art, as it's always the case in with my Druyer videos. So I will end this right here, right now. And I really hope that the measurements for the night are not really as they have been in the solicitations. Thanks for listening and watching. Goodbye.